Ibrahim.
Thank you.
uguayo hapa.
Beka. Beka.
Thank you.
We are here for a very unique occasion. Not all of us have been that much expectant. Today, by His grace, is going to be the third edition of this great competition that is coming up in, here on campus, OAU campus. But as you know, a competition of this magnitude, there is a need for us to start whatsoever we intend doing here today for all to work well and for God to take charge. Absolutely, there is a need for us to bring in the Lord. We have two people here that have been recognized to pray for us. They are dignitaries, but even at that, they'll be the one to open the floor with prayers. We have our daddy here in the house who is going to do the opening ceremony, opening prayer. And that is a person of Engineer Adebole Mustafa. Can we please put our hands together? More, 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 more. Can we come to you? Thank you very much, our engineer. You will not be surprised that we have quite a number of very important personalities in the house. Very quickly, because of our time, we'd like to seek the indulgence of some six dignitaries on the high table. We have in the house the TM for the Obafemi Awolowo University, who is there with us, Professor Esu Baramashi. Shall we just put our hands together? Please let's join our hands together. More. More. Thank you. Proper well. God bless you. Again, you will not be surprised that the man who came, the engineer who came to offer the opening prayer, very short and powerful prayer session, the same person that you see right on the high table, we call it high table, but we know what exactly it is. Engineer, you please step forward. Engineer, Adebole Mustafa, you please. Thank you. Yes, sir. Let's take a hand to learn more for them. Well, when we are talking about dignitaries, all of us are very important. But you and I know that even when we have so many seats here, not everybody will be there. But then, all of us are important before God Almighty. Now, the second person who is going to be taught, who will sit on the high table, we have engineer Jimmy Tope. We've been called to the high table. Just then we have our mommy, our host, the chairman of OAU Sports Council, that is Obafemi Awolowo University Sports Council. She is the chairman. She came in just while some distinguished are taking their seats there. Mommy is Professor Mrs. Y. Anderson. That is William C. Anderson. Thank you very much. Also, very quickly, we have
the chairman is the comfortable law that passed. Okay, that is where we are together. You are ready.
Thank you.
We have Professor Eddie Tijani, who came in just a while, and also her beautiful wife, Coach B. We call her Coach B. She's in charge of judo here in Obafemi Awolowo. You will not believe it that I'm just told now that during her days, no one challenges her. Oh, even now, if she puts on her judogi, am I correct? Yes, on the mat. Oh my God, she need not to tackle any man on the mat. Let me repeat, on the mat. She is a judo coach here.
Yeah!
He has not come to play, rather there's an award waiting for him right here in this Obasanjo Award University Hall. And also we have our new lad, this time one, very sharp player she is, and award is awaiting her this afternoon. So two of them, it is time for them to receive their award. We shall call them out. But in the meantime, there is a need for us to know who these awardees are, the recipients. I'd appreciate if you would join me here. Mr. Rigman, let's come here. Seven times he reigned in ping pong. Now this is not the time for citations. We won't do that when the time comes. But just to show you who is the big one, that's the common talent that has been out of.
I am telling you, it's very honor.
same body. You can keep it for going on. Ladies and gentlemen, perhaps we have a lot of that is the PAP owner, then the doctor. The PAP member, he knows table. He understands it very well.
Please put your hands together for Ariana today.
So on behalf of here sponsors special, and especially Dr. Kaulo is going to do the association and presenting you this award.
A graduate of Tashua, Tai Sri Lami University of Education, I'm talking about Udeyi. I saw him play, I looked away. What is special about this guy? Please step forward. There's something special about him, and there is something about me. We don't keep doing the same thing the same way, and we want people to have more interest in that thing. We want innovations, and that is the hallmark of advancement. If we want to promote the game of table tennis, we need to have what the Chinese people have. It is not just about playing the game. There are skills that you don't necessarily see in the shake hand, but you see in the tempo. I saw him, I called him yesterday, and I told him I'm going to showcase him. And today, please put your hands together for him. He's here. Permit me to spend 5 minutes with him on the table tennis board to show you what he's doing. Thank you.
an inspiring one. This is what we are all called to do. I think the first thing is to praise the sacrificial spirit of the organizers of this program, because all of them, they've been doing this thing without waiting for what is in it for me. They put their resources, their time, their talent, their energy, and their influence to bring this to bear, to develop our youth, our tomorrow, and of course to promote sports. I mean, there's so much to be said. I mean, so much gained from sports development. And these days that we are talking of youth unemployment, drug addiction, insurgency, and all of these things, these are useful ways to engage our youths. And that's why we cannot but thank them enough. By being here today, is to support them. I wish I have the whole world to give to them, because they are doing the right thing. Expecting government to do all may not happen like that. We are the government, and I'm sure they are leading us. They've shown us the way that this is the right thing to do. I know many of them there, they are just doing their best without anybody even saying thank you, but they continue all the same. So we thank them, and we look forward to all of us also acting this way to take Nigeria to the promised land that we all desire. Thank you very much for covering this beautiful event. And I pray together Nigeria will continue to move forward. Thank you. God bless you.
Thank you very much for this beautiful interview. I think the first thing the government should do is to provide enablers for the facilities. Because without facilities, we will not discover talent. We have a lot of raw talent, especially here in Osun State. I believe we can do better. So the first thing in every zone of Osun State, like Ifo Central, the only school facility in Ifo Central is Obafemi Awolowo University. What if you don't have Obafemi Awolowo University? What about those talents there that they don't have the opportunity to be on campus? Where would they execute their talents? So in every zone, every community, they should be in, even if it's going to be a recreation center, you can develop talent from recreation. You can develop passion from recreating. I started sports by recreating, and before I knew it, I developed the passion for it. So I want to plead on the Osun State government generally that they should make an enabling, conducive environment. They should spend money on sports, because there is money on sports. Sports is a money-making machine. We have them out there. Look at what Coach Remy is doing. Coach Remy is a grassroots coach. So if the government can provide the facilities, when you have the facilities, you will be pushed to do the sport. Because assuming there's a football pitch, and already you are a good football, nobody needs to tell you. When you have said that, you are, wow, this is football, you will really want to go and play football. So they should make sports a priority. It becomes a lot of juvenile delinquency. You know, if you look at our youth now, they smoke, they drink, they don't do all those things. But if you get yourself in sports, you won't have time to drink. Because from morning to night, maybe you are in the gym, or you are in your table tennis, or you are in a judo dojo, you are doing your game. Who will not tell you to come and smoke? You won't do that. Because you know, when you smoke, it will reduce your energy. So that is just, they should provide facilities. We need facilities. The talent are there. When we don't have the facilities, the competent hands are there too. The technocrats. We have them in Osun State. Yes, we have the technocrats there. But you cannot send a farmer to the farm without giving him what is going to work.
Thank you for having me. As it is now, I don't think we have to leave sports development in the hand of the government. Both the government and the public will have to join hands together to ensure that we uplift the game of table tennis, especially in Osun State. You understand? Gone were those days when individuals developed themselves. Now, both governments, like I said, and public will have to come together and see what they can do in terms of provision of facilities. When I say facilities, I mean table tennis court, I mean table tennis courts, I also mean the table tennis rubber and the kids. You understand? Most of these things that I mentioned have now become so expensive that they are not within the reach of individuals. It is the table tennis players. They are not something that they can afford, you know, on their own. So we need individuals who are sports oriented, who feel they need to contribute to sports. And thank God we are seeing some of them coming up now, but we need to encourage those ones too, you understand? And that is where I feel the government needs to come in. Identify those individuals and see how they can encourage them so that they can do more. And that way, we can still look for more people who will help to develop the game. The game has developed to the extent that it's no longer something that you play, you know, on the street or on the road and so on. You understand? It's recognized worldwide. You understand? And people are now becoming professionals. Nigeria as a country has also produced professionals. Yeah? Like Haruna Kodi, who was once a player, you know. You understand? So we need to look or fish them out while they are still young. And that is why we need some grassroots programs. Grassroots programs. To organize such, you understand, we also need money. Just like what we are doing today. It's just a way of, you know, scouting for new talents. Those that we can catch young and see how we can develop them. So I want to believe that if government is willing, you understand, this guy will give the limits. Because all they need to do is, they don't really have to pump in too much money, but they have to create an environment that will be conducive for training. You understand? And the athletes themselves need to be encouraged. So if we can do this, I want to believe that in the next 5-10 years, the sports in Osun State will have, you know, been moved, you know, forward. I want to believe that.
Well, my name is Taiwo Akinola Aweyemi. I'm a trained sports psychologist and a trained sports coach. In respect of your question, what can the government do to enhance the sporting facilities in Osun State? The government is trying on our own part, but there are various challenges. Very few governments in Nigeria pick interest in sports. Very few. And sport is a veritable tool to enhance health, to promote well-being, to facilitate development at local level, state level, and international levels, at national levels. Sports, if government invest in sports, they will take so many youth away from crime. Issue of drug abuse will be very, very minimal. We can enhance our economy, both individual, personal economy, community economy, state economy, and national economy via sport. Sport is an element in tourism. Are we promoting sports? Sports have a diverse, is a very table tools in which the United Nations has picked to use that to facilitate development and peace globally. It's one of the development goals, sustainable development goals, right from 2000 when they started. The government should pick interest. These facilities is a federal facility because this is a federal school. Some years back, when the missionary instituted the school, ventured into the school, you see that all the schools then have sporting facility because of the emphasis they place on it, because of the value they play on sports. Sports, physical activities, is a medium of communication and expression in which we add physical values, social values, psychological values, and economic and socio-economic, socio-political values. So I will encourage the government to invest in sporting facilities And we are saying our children are getting involved in crime. Why not? They want to recreate. They want to see what is available to them is what they will take into. But if there are sporting facilities in schools with personnel to train them, then when they get to the community level, there are facilities, then they will, it will be there for them to use. Individual can develop facilities to develop, to support the government. But the government has a larger role because the government has the larger resources. Likewise, the voluntary organizations can support the government. The business entity can support the government. The government cannot do it alone. Those whom God has blessed, they can support the government. But the government can start somewhere. One in one community, in one local government, up to the time that we get to all the wards. At the state level, they can zone it. Okay, we have this facility developed by state in one of the 6 geopolitical zones in Osun State. Later to other zones, the state government. The federal can have its own in any state, supporting the states. So that's your
professionally. But before then, what have you been involved?
Using papers, tie and slates to play with my brothers at 5.
From age 5. I heard that you are in the service now.
Yes, sir. I would say they should not drop anything they have passion for, irrespective of the challenges they are facing in life. What you have passion for goes a long way in your, even in academics. Once you drop, I noticed that major people don't like sports because of the society belief, and so even for the females, there is no more encouragement for the females when it comes to sports. And it affects them to the point of their various endeavors in life because they have dropped what they have passion for. The rest is just because they force them to do one or two things. They have stopped them in doing that one. And for them to have another, to derive passion for other things, it will be very difficult for them to do that. what they have passion for. They should not let it die. What they have, their talent should not go wasted just like that. I will say thank you to Coach Afolaremi Bangbokba for his continual support for the grassroots, the youth entirely in when it comes to sports. He has been the best, actually. He has been looking out forward for young players to bring them into limelight. I'm Olufunlaye Adegbega from Ogun State.
My name is Akunde Kabirat. I'm from Oyo State. I've been started table tennis since when I'm in Primary 4. That's 2014. I grew to table tennis all by myself. And the name of my coach is Coach Ayatu.
Coach Ayatu.
He coaches very well and tell us everything about table tennis. I've gained a lot. I have never traveled in my life before, but when I started playing table tennis, I've been going to many states like Lagos State, Abuja, many states. I want to thank my coach for everything. And I want to thank you, and I want to thank Coach Remy for this organization.
Ayo State.
My name is Akorede Kabirat. I'm from Ayo State.
God bless. Akorede
Kabirat.
Kabirat.
From Ayo State.
From Ayo State. God bless you.
Thank you, sir.
My name is Ayobamida. I'm from Ayo State. Just like, because it is fun, sha. It is fun, and I have passion for it. I'm about 10 years old.
When you started?
The only thing I have to say is that you just have to do whatever you have passion for. Whatever you like, whatever you feel like doing. You don't have to be discouraged by anything. I want to appreciate all the people that organized this competition for giving us the opportunity to participate in this competition. I think it's important. My name is Evan Bell.
My name is Afolabi Olamijuno. First and foremost, let me say glory be to God for the starting of the game and for the ending of the game. So, more so, from the female aspects, I've started the game as a youth. Playing with them at this tournament, I just feel like I should encourage them. Being a woman, despite the fact that they are youth, upcoming athletes, they are grassroots players. So I encourage them by joining myself with them, playing with them. So one more muscle, we need more female players, especially in our state. We don't have any female player, as I'm talking right now, apart from a lady, which her name is Taiwo. She based in Ife Ye. She's the only female that we have in the state at the moment.
In Osun
State at the moment. So we need more players. We need more organizers. We need more sponsors on the event on Osun State. Organizer of this competition as well is trying. He's trying to say the fact he's trying, because this is not the first edition. This is the second edition or third edition, if I'm correct. The female player, we need to strategize by going out to the parents, encourage the parents by talking to them individually to let them know what sport's all about. It's not just being playing all alone. There's a lot of benefit in the sports, a lot. If a person is into a sport now, playing that particular game, you can as well gain fitness all over your body, your health, and all that. You feel okay. So at the same time, we need more female player in the States. We need more female player in the States. And as per male player, we need more male player as well in the States. Coaches. In states, definitely, they should be able to go out, speak to the parents concerning any event that individual might find him or herself in doing. Definitely, I believe sports will definitely be growing. Well, let me say, this is not the first and this is not the second, which and as well pray for him that this one will not be the last as well. I pray for him that the last one he did was not good as this one. As good one as this one good, the other one will more better than this one. By God's grace, by inshallah, it will be more better than this one. And more so, we want, like I said, we want Oga, we want sponsorers. We want sponsors to sponsor sports. To sponsor sports, starting from Glo, starting from MTN, starting from Mr. V, Bottle Water, and all that. In fact, like individual that God enrich their pocket, not those big companies like that. Even if it is people that has money on their own and they have interest in the sport as well, they can also come out and encourage upcoming athletes. There's a lot to benefit from the sport. Not just spending all your money all alone into the sport. You gain a lot from there as well. So for the organizers for today, I pray for him that God will prosper him in whatsoever he lays his hand onto. He shall be well with him. My name is Afolabi Jalila Tolamijulo.
I am a public servant. I work with an NGO. So far, the Afolaremi initiative has been a very nice initiative. And it is an improvement for us. If a young man like that has that kind of initiative to do things like this and bringing the younger ones and developing the younger ones. It is a wonderful thing to do. And the program has been so far successful. Where you see the commissioner of the state coming down, that means it will show you that a lot of effort have gone into it. So he has done a lot. But we thank God that he's here. And the commissioner will see what he can do. Improving the game in the state. So the government have to do a lot in sport. if we are serious wanting to develop the younger ones, we have to be serious as well. And thank God, many people are coming in now who want to actually improve sport, especially table tennis in the state now. In the next few months, the table tennis in the state of Osun will be giving a very, very international standard face, whereby you have a philanthropist that have come, who is spending what the state cannot do. You understand? That is something. So that we even encourage some other people to come and invest in whatever area of sports they like. But with regards to table tennis, I think the state has been blessed. I want to use this opportunity to actually thank His Excellency, the Governor of the state, Alhaji Isaac Agboyega, who has actually given the land where these philanthropies can build, you know, a hall, a table tennis hall for the state. If he has not given the land, something wouldn't happen. You understand? So we have to appreciate His Excellency there, and of course the Commissioner as well, who has been doing wonderfully well in seeing. But there is a lot to do in terms of sport. If we actually want to mobilize the community, we actually want to mobilize our people, we can go through sport. There are a lot of talents there that we're wasting, and we have to discover them. And how do you do that? It is by putting infrastructures down whereby these younger ones can come and, you know, develop their talents. And at the end of the day, it will be a source of revenue generation for the state. My name is Tokwe Mustafa Adeyemi.
Representing himself. Very sure that he will be representing here by his grace. His Excellency, the Governor of our dear state, Alhaji Isaac Agboyega.
That's another one of other members of the those that are very special in the house that we need to recognize. But time is not on our side. However, we will call the names. We have reached the final stage. The Honorable Commissioner will speak when the time comes. We will be able to probably watch the final for this afternoon. We know that Yanni Uruigi of Honorable Commissioner, you are here to watch the best of people at this time, particularly at this new time period. Once again, you are welcome, sir. And we want to compete with Yanni Uruigi is Aziz Yahaya. Before they got to meet the spirit of money and a place, and time and a place on their name. And how do I mean by time? You see, I'm a combat. He owns the group. Who is he getting here? How do you call him after? He is the result of the people of our business. And some people who saw me that are paying their tax, they must be checking the sizes. So let's start asking about it. And the part that here, too, they chose to unconscious. The people sitting down on the far left here, too, they chose to sit down there to give honor to the man or to the president. Of course, the president of the Honorable Commissioner will be coming to present His Excellency this afternoon.
Thank you. Thank you.
is ambassador of the Ambassador of Sports Award, Honorable Ayode Alade. We talk about the people that have together.
As you are all aware, we're lucky the
people we have at the level of the association are very, very supportive, very, very responsible people. They are putting up an indoor sport hall for table tennis at Oshogbo Stadium. I have been very quiet about it because I've been quite skeptical whether the project is going to stop. But I've been made to understand that the building has been covered already. That shows a very high level of commitment. I thank you very much. I have come and I have seen, and I can tell you I will report to the appropriate authorities. For the winner in the male category, we shall support him. And I will say, for the winner in the female category, so we shall support him.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Standing on the existing protocol, I want to appreciate the presence of the Honorable Commissioner for Youth Sports and Special Events in Osun State, Honorable Yemi Lawal. This is very important today. He has done what many commissioners from the time past that have done in Osun State. We appreciate you, sir. Thank you very much, sir. I want to thank Honorable Ayodeji Alabi, Chairman of Osun State. Please put your hands together for him. Engineer Ayodeji Mustafa, I thank you, sir. Tafla Motors, the Chairman of Tafla Motors. Thank you very much, sir. The Chairman, Easy Table Tennis Club. Thank you, sir, for coming. I also want to appreciate my own director, the director of the Ministry of Youth and Sports, in the person of Mr. Lai Adeshina. Thank you for your kindness, for encouraging me, for encouraging this vision, for encouraging the players in all sports in Osun State. Thank you for your good work, sir. We thank the entourage of the Honorable Commissioner, who has represented our state governor here today in person of Alhaji Adegbuyega Oyetola. Please put your hands together for the governor of our state. Thank you, sir. I want to appreciate the people who have stood behind this vision, starting from Mr. Femi Oni, the lecturer in Basketball. He always say, "Coach, mi shadi shele, coach, mi bule bashele, coach, mi kilo shele." That's his name. Thank you very much, sir. He is a good organizer. I want to thank Ogbeni Charles. Like I said in that song, "Eleno Pa." Thank you very much, sir. Yes, if I play with you, things that we did before, you know that he indeed won Leno. Yes, the Mr. Support. If we can also find Mr. Support, he can support anything. He sees any vision, he supports it. He says he believes in bringing people up. He wants to write, he just hold your hand and do the thing. Engineer Ayodeji Babatunde Jacobs, thank you very much for your work. Apart from this, the Obafemi Awolowo University Table Tennis player and team says thank you once again. We want to appreciate you all. for training so hard and for being here and for not getting a word. I said something they say about the table tennis players. They say on my table, I fought that thing in this office yesterday. They believe we are cunning. They believe that we are noble. They say all bad things about us. We are rogues. They thought we are rogues, but we are proving them wrong now. Please keep doing that. For any reason, universities, there are universities at workforce today here to say you have done anything wrong, and that is commitment. Thank you very much for being here. We appreciate you for it. And we also want to tell you that for everything that we have done here, if you have seen any error, we are just starting. Please keep us passing. We are. We want to thank you for coming. I want to appreciate it. Lastly, the stage coach, Mr. Ayo, Mr. Tali has been living. I really love this man. He has supported this dream. He sold forms. He took forms to places. You would think he was the one organizing the program. So if you have seen any good organization from Oshogbo quarters, that is him, Mr. Tali.
Comfortable table tennis, Osun State, first ever in Osun State. We really appreciate the initiative of the organizer. It's very, very, very unique and it's very nice. And we really appreciate him for bringing up the grassroots sports for our players in Osun State. So we really thank him. God will be blessing him and taking him up from there. Now, the only thing that I can say about this thing is from our grassroots, we need to do more for our players so that they can be competitive with other players from other states. We need individual sponsorship for the players so that even if the government cannot do it, then the sponsorship can help the players to make better play from that they derive their so that their talent can be seen out as elsewhere. We thank you. We expect more of it and better competition next year. We are very grateful. Ms. Adi Emadosu from UCF from Otim Tennis of State.
I'm from Oyo. Name is Yekin Deji. I was very happy and excited for the third position that I won. Although it is by God's grace, but I appreciate our sponsors as well.
Ayola.
Ayola Kabirat.
Ayola Kabirat.
From Oyo State. I win the first position in this competition and I'm very happy to win. I thank them very well and I pay them well.
Yeah, it's been a very awesome event. We thank God it's better than the one we had last year. We are grateful to God it's improving and we believe we will keep improving. Yeah, we bless God. The representative of the governor was here today, the commissioner for youth and sports himself. We had a very nice one. People from Oyo were able to take the day in the girls' category. People from Oshogbo were able to take the day in the men's category. We bless God for this. And we urge our governments to please put more input, more fund into sports, particularly my own sport. Ping pong. Okay. It shall be well. Thank you, sir.
Thanks, sir. Your name, yes. Sir?
I'm Femi Oni, and why I play this is not really for competition, but for my health. I enjoy it so much. It's been helping me, and I know it will keep helping.
This is Ogbeni Tunde. In total support of the table tennis competition today, you know, all the way from Lagos, it's been a very wonderful experience. We've got lots of talents here. And then we also thank the Honorable Commissioner for Youth and Sports, Osun State, who was here to witness the occasion. And we hope by next year, we're still going to be better than this. We've learned a lot from this edition, and we'll take it up from here next year. It's going to be better than this, and we're going to get more people competing and more talent that we're going to be able to bring up through this competition. Thank you, guys.
Oh, yeah. Let's go. Yo,
it's all true for Wala.
Oh, yeah, Dama.
My name is Jacobs. Today's program, well established, and it's the second of its kind. And we were being represented by different kind of athletes, team tennis players from different kind of the states. And the organizer happens to be our coach, better coach, Coach Remy, has been so wonderfully planned this with the support of God and the support of some able men in Osun State and the IFE, to be precise. We thank God for the success of this tournament, and we are hoping to do more next year in a bigger and well organized tournament next year by the grace of God. I am a lover of tennis. I love it so much that I can put whatever it takes to make the tournament and to make table tennis players go far and wide. We need to encourage these people, you know. And I really appreciated our Minister of Sports that came out today to cheer the sport people up. And this is the kind of person we want, you know. Encourage our players, push them more, so that those youngster half court, they will feel, you know, feel accepted when it comes to sport. Not that someone that was pushing them away, that go and read your book. No, education is okay, it's fine. But there are so many talented players out there that needed support. So I'm using this medium to invite several people that want to sponsor, that want to encourage good players in Osun, so that Osun State can be one of the best when it comes to table tennis, or when it comes to sports in the World Federation. My name is Jacob, so what's in your heritage?
Good day, Nigerians. Good day, my fellow youth in Osun State, in all the states in Nigeria, in Africa, and to all blacks in diaspora. I want to say thank you for supporting this vision. I am Afolaremi Bankole Bangbokwa, a native of Osun State. I hail from Edonabon in Ife North local government of Osun State. I am the visionary founder of AIM Foundation Africa and AIM Sports Special, a subordinate group under Afolaremi Initiative for Impact Movement in Africa. This vision is not just for me. It is not about making anything for myself, but an initiative that others can replicate. We want to push people, we want to charge people to take up the responsibility of leadership at a young age. We don't want to wait till you're 48, 49, 50, 90, before you think you want to take up the leadership responsibility in Africa. This has been the problem that we have faced. This is why we are where we are. And that is what I want us to change. That is why I'm coming up and to tell you that you are a leader, you are a born leader, take up the challenge and lead Africa to greatness. Thank you very much for this opportunity. Afolaremi Initiative for Impact Movement started in the year 2018. On the 10th of March 2018 precisely, we had the foundation launching at Hilton Hotel in Ilefe. And today, since then, we have held at least four programs, major programs, yearly, starting from the foundation launching and the activities to encourage the physically challenged individuals in our community. And of course, it was a successful one. That's 2018. We had a table tennis tournament. In 2019, we had Okeirun Day table tennis competition. In 2020, there was Courage to Leave table tennis and soccer championships. It was just to bring the youth out of the lockdown. Because after the lockdown, many people did not know what to do. People had stayed so much at home. They didn't even know where to go. They were not having fun. So as long as the lockdown was eased, I said, okay, let's bring this. And people were joyous. They were so happy to participate. And in 2021, which is this year, they just concluded Great Ife Table Tennis Championship. I own that to God Almighty. I own that to everyone who has supported the vision. I own that to the youth who will see this vision and catch it and take up leadership roles in other areas of life. The AIM Sports Special was not for table tennis alone. You know, in 2020, it was about football and table tennis. In 2021, it was table tennis, but in a grand style. We had little groups participating in that in 2020. And if you see 2021, we have expanded it. We are growing bigger. And by 2022, I want to promise you more activities, more developmental activities, more community-based, more grassroots-based developmental programs. So expect that from Afolaremi Initiative for Impact Movements in Africa. Expect that from AIM Sports Special. Then I'm seeing, other than table tennis in 2022, I'm seeing table tennis tournaments, a national one. I'm seeing badminton tournaments and other sports coming up before that year runs out. I'm also seeing taking sports to our correctional facilities so that these people can also be impacted, can sufficiently stay active for their wellness, and other programs, such as educational programs and all, we want these things to come up so that people will actually know that the youth can do these things. The youth can actually, I don't know where they saw, where it was written that the youth cannot lead, the youth cannot be president, the youth cannot govern. We are doing it in our little capacities. So I'm challenging everyone to move up to that. That is why I'm fronting this initiative. And I want you to catch it. In fact, I want more African youth, more black youth, more Osun State youth, more Nigerian youth to start having visions like this. By this, we will lessen the burden on the shoulder of the government. Then we will see a clearer vision, a clearer picture of tomorrow. Then what we did not have, we would be able to give it to the upcoming generation. And when they come, they will build on it. So this is what Afolaremi Initiative for Impact Movement in Africa Foundation is about. Thank you very much for listening. Thank you for being with us. Thank you for supporting us. We will continue to surprise you with good activities in the community. God bless you. So one thing that will keep this initiative moving is support. We solicit for your support. We want you to support all our initiatives, and we want to thank those who have been supporting us from the time past. I want to say, give a big kudos to the present chairperson of Obafemi Awolowo University Sports Council in person of Professor YB Yenusa. I want to thank Mrs. Adeshola. I also give kudos to our dear Mr. Support, Mr. Jacobs Babatunde. I also want to appreciate Crown FM as a group. I want to appreciate the sports presenters. I want to appreciate Swan Osun State. I want to appreciate everyone who has contributed to the success of this year's program. I remember Mr. Femi Oni. He's been so wonderful. He's supported with everything he has. Thank you, Mr. Femi Oni. Thank you, Mr. Jacobs Babatunde, and all his friends. I also want to appreciate the present governor of Osun State, Alhaji Isiaka Adegboye Gao Yetola, for being with us during the program in representation through the office of the Commissioner for Youth and Sports of the state of Osun. I want to appreciate especially the Commissioner for Youth and Sports, Honorable Aziz Olayemi Lawal. Thank you very much for being with us. Thank you for all your promises, and we hope that these promises will be fulfilled soon, so that these guys who have heard it can also smile. Thank you very much. Once again, I want to appreciate God's Foundation Media. They have been so wonderful. They were with us last year. This year, if they did not do well, if their work was not good, we will not have them back this year. So we hope that we'll continue to develop this organization together and to develop our community together. I also want to appreciate the Osun State Table Tennis Association, from the chairman to the secretary to the financial secretary to all the members of the group. Thank you very much, sir, for your support. I know without your support, without your backing, this CS program might be successful, but will not be as good as it was. Thank you very much for supporting us. I want to say a big thank you to the Sports Council of Obafemi Awolowo University and its management. I also appreciate my father, Oba Akinola Akinrera, the Olubosin of Ifetedo Kingdom of Osun State, for his support. He has supported anything sport. Thank you very much, sir. We wish you more years on the throne, and we wish you more grace in life. I want to appreciate everyone in my family who has supported my vision, who has encouraged me with words of prayer and with everything they have to support. Thank you very much to every one of you. I will continue to be the person you have dreamed of me to be. Thank you very much. God bless you. Once again, I remain your own. Afolaremi, Bamkole, Bangbopa, popularly known as Better Coach. I will continue to be that kind of person you have dreamed of me to be in the community. I will lead, I will appreciate, I will teach, and I will enhance. Trust me, transformation is possible. So we will transform this country together. We will transform our communities together. Thank you very much. God bless you.